Tori, Grant, and Carrie have found that trying to clout your way out of a casket, Kill Bill style, ain't all it's cracked up to be. But as a potential final nail in this myth's coffin, there's one last part to test.
Now, we've busted the part of the myth where you could punch through a casket. But now what we're going to do is we're going to test the part of the myth that if you did bust through the casket, could you dig through 6 feet of dirt? So what I need to do is I need to reconfigure this rig here so that we can get inside of it and safely try to dig our way out.
Now, if the movie heroine was superhuman or the coffin lid riddled with woodworm, maybe she could have punched through. And if so, could she then have escaped? To find out, Tori replaces the casket lid with a sliding hatch to hold back the dirt above.
All right, so this is the trap door. It's gonna open like that, and then we'll start digging our way out.
He's also built an acrylic casket with a specially designed escape hatch that's all ready for a trial run.
So the new casket's in place, and what I'm gonna do right now is just test the trap door and see if it's working. Oh, it works. And I'm out safely.
Well, sort of safely.
Better than dying.
Meanwhile, Grant's got the dirt on dirt.
So dirt weighs between 65 and 88 pounds per cubic foot. And we know from our buried in sand experiment that those types of pressures on your chest cavity can get very dangerous very quick. Now, traditionally, caskets are buried 6 feet under dirt. But for safety, we're gonna start out with just 2 feet.
But even only 2 feet under, Carrie, for one, is sure Tori's digging his own grave.
I have a feeling the coffin's gonna fill up and pin him before he's able to dig his way out.
So, pepped up by Carrie's confidence, Tori puts on an anti-crush suit.
Yeah, this ought to stop the dirt from compressing my lungs.
And, most important, a fire brigade breathing apparatus.
Go, is this how Houdini died?
One panicked look later, and it's go time.
Be careful in there.
Tori carefully slides his way into the coffin as he prepares to literally put his life on the line.
You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, I'm gonna open the door slowly.
All of a sudden, this seems like a horrible idea.
Tori's burial ritual begins. Carrie releases the trap door, exactly as if he'd been able to punch a hole in that coffin lid. The trickle of dirt begins to fall in on him.
Bro, this is freaky.
Okay, keep going. Yeah, keep going.
Carrie opens it wider, and it rapidly becomes an avalanche. And it's panic stations below.
Whoa, 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 stop, stop.
I'm all right, I'm all right. No, I'm okay. I'm all right.
The 2 feet of dirt has caved in on him, but there's a bonus. It's opened up a rabbit hole above.
Daylight.
But still trapped. He pushes the dirt to the bottom of the coffin, wriggles, and then scrapes his way upright, and with a massive effort, actually triumphs in tunneling his way out.
Ah! I'm alive!
Tori's proved that at 2 feet under, assuming you could open the coffin lid, escape is just conceivable. But the myth calls for a normal burial.
Now, our next setup is gonna be under the full 6 feet of dirt.
Yep, you heard right, folks. Grant is going to be buried a full 6 feet under. But so he doesn't die, his plan is to sit up, not lie down in the coffin. Okay, let's pause for Carrie's prediction.
Think about 4 feet. It's all gonna collapse down and completely go pear-shaped.
Okay, Carrie, go ahead.
Carrie at last dishes the dirt on Grant.
Keep going.
Thousands of pounds of soil slithers south.
Okay, stop!
And almost immediately, Grant's buried to the neck, unable to move, at least until the rig breaks under the pressure. It's easy to see that if Grant had been lying down, he'd be dead.
Well, I guess that worked well.
Yeah, I think that pretty much sums it up.
The air tunnel that Tori used never opened up for Grant, and that meant escape was totally impossible.